Hi everyone, and welcome to the Global Azure Virtual 2020. My name is Véronique Langelet. I am a Microsoft MVP. I work as a Microsoft 365 productivity consultant for a Microsoft partner, and I'm based in Scotland. I am a course author. I blog a lot. I am a dog lover, and on my spare time, I like photography. So if you like photography and you've never been in Scotland, I would highly recommend it because the scenery is absolutely stunning. So in this session, we are going to talk about Azure Access Reviews. What are Access Reviews? What is the licensing model that we need? What are the benefits of using Azure Access Reviews? And then we'll jump into the first demo on how to configure Access Reviews from the Azure portal, how to use Access Reviews, and that will be from a reviewer point of view. And we'll also briefly touch on the reporting capabilities. So what are Azure Access Reviews? Well, like it says, it is for you to review the access. And you can review the access to group memberships, applications, and also roles. They are available via the Azure portal. And the main goal is to review the access on a regular basis. So we'll dig a bit more into this later on. And overall, this is going to reduce the admin overhead, and that will allow you to stay in control as much as possible from who has access to what and should they keep their access. Now, what type of license do you need to use Azure Access Reviews? And especially, who's gonna need one? So to use Azure Access Reviews, you need an Azure AD Premium P2, or if you have an Enterprise Mobility and Security, aka EMS, and you need an E5 for this, because the EMS E5 will give you an Azure AD P2. Now, this was the easy part. Let's see who needs an Azure AD P2 or an EMS E5. Well, members or guests who are reviewers, group owners who are performing the review, or we also have an option when we configure Access Reviews that will allow you to ask the member or the user himself or herself to review their access. And this is called self-review. So if this is the option you choose when you want to create a new Access Review, every single user will need to have a license. And finally, application owners like the group owners we've seen previously. We have some exceptions. And this is only an exception for setting up the access reviews. So if you are a global admin or a user admin and you are configuring the access reviews. Now, what are the benefits of using Azure Access Reviews? Well, you will have regular checks even when the IT team is busy. So you don't need to set up a calendar reminder and then send email to everybody. It works with internal users as well as guests. And we can review the most important roles, which are obviously the admins. And the good thing here as well is that you delegate to a group or an application owner the task to review the access for their members. Because let's face it, they should know better than you do who should have access to their resources. And for all the developers out there, Access Reviews are also available using the Microsoft Graph APIs. So far, sounds kind of good, right? But one of the major benefits from using Azure Access Reviews is for the IT team, because this is going to reduce the admin overhead. Like I mentioned before, you don't need to create a new task, you don't need to set a reminder in your calendar, and we'll see that during our first demo, which is coming next, on how to configure the access reviews, and you can set the review as low as weekly and as far as annually. So let's jump into our first demo on how to configure the Azure Access Reviews. Okay, so we are currently in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. If you have an Azure subscription, you can go directly through the Azure portal. But if you have an EMS E5 subscription, you need to go into your Azure Active Directory Admin Center from your Microsoft 365 tenant. So let's click on Azure Active Directory. And if you've never been into the Azure Active Directory portal, we need to find our access reviews. So click on All Services, and we can start looking for Access Reviews. And as you can see, they are under Identity Governance. So let's pin that to the left panel by clicking on the star. Now click on Identity Governance. And we can see at the top, because we've never used the access reviews, that we need to click on Onboard on the left navigation. So let's just do this. And then click on Onboard Now. Now the onboarding was successful. Let's go back to our access reviews. We can click on Access Reviews on the sidebar, or we also have Create an Access Review from the main menu. One or the other is fine. Okay, so now let's start the configuration. We need to give our review a name. We can give it a description if we want to, and we need to choose a start date. So by default, it would be today's date, which is the 18th of April. But we can choose a later date if we want to. Let's say that we want to start on Monday. Then, like I said briefly on the slides, we can configure the frequency. And you have a few choices there. We have a one-time review, weekly, monthly, quarterly, semi-annually, or annually. So let's choose monthly. Next, we have the duration in days. And this is currently set to 14 days. So it means that the reviewer will have 14 days to review the membership. Then we can choose when do we want this review to end. So we have never, and then everything will be grayed out. We have end by. We can specify a certain date, or we have occurrences. How many times do you want this review to occur? So let's choose an end date. Under the users section, we have members of a group or assigned to an application. For the purpose of this demo, just choose member of a group. And then for the scope, do we want to review the access for the guests only or for everyone? Let's choose everyone and select our group. Let's try to find a group and take the finance team. Once you've selected it, click on select. And now we need to choose who are going to be our reviewers. So let's expand that. And we have group owners, selected users, or members themselves. Now, remember that this is important from a licensing perspective. If you choose group owners or selected users, you need to make sure that those people have the appropriate license. But if you choose members themselves, then everyone in this finance group will need to have a license assigned to them. So you have pros and cons for each of those three. If you choose group owners or selected users, you are going to put an additional task for them, which will be reviewing on a monthly basis the access to the group. But you might only need a few licenses for this. If you select members themselves, it might be more efficient, but at the same time, you will need to assign 100 licenses if the group has 100 members. So let's choose group owners. For the programs, the default program will always be here, but you can create a new program if you want to. Let's say a finance program or a GDPR program. Once the reviewers have reviewed the membership, what do you want to happen? Do we want to auto-apply the results? Yes or no? And what happens if the reviewers actually do not respond to the access review? Again, for the purpose of this demo, we're going to choose enable. And then if they don't respond, we can choose between no change, remove access, approve the access. So those ones are kind of self-explanatory. And then we have tech recommendations. And we'll see in the next demo that if we choose tech recommendations, we will have a separate column with some insight that Microsoft is giving us regarding the access for a specific user. So let's choose recommendations. And the last few settings we have in here are to require a reason for approval. Do we want any mail notifications or any reminders? Now, one thing I didn't mention, but you see this little eye for information. So every time you're going to hover over it, you will get more insight on what the setting is about. Now let's click on Start. And our new access review has been created. Let's refresh the page. And it is now visible. Let's jump into our second demo on how to use Azure Access Reviews from a reviewer perspective. Now we are logged with a different account, and I'm logged as Alex. And because I am an owner of this finance team group and we've configured as such, I receive an email saying that I need to review the user access for the finance team. And I also have the deadline for the review. When ready, click on Start Review. And from this page, we can see all the members for the finance team group. Now, currently, the recommendation is to deny the access, and we have a reason. It's because they haven't signed for the past 30 days, but maybe those users are new users joining the team, or maybe they should really not have access anymore. So we can select the user and either approve, continue to deny the access, maybe we don't know, or simply accept the recommendation. For this user, I'm going to approve and give a reason why. Then click on Submit. And we have our decision as approved. Let's do the same for the other ones. We can also click on Details. And we have a little summary of the current decision, as well as maybe you want to change your decision. Once we have reviewed all the memberships, everything has been sent automatically from the moment you clicked on the Submit button. And our final demo will be about Azure Access Reviews reporting. Back in the Azure AD portal, let's go to our Access Reviews. We can now see that the status is active. Let's click on it to see what we've got. We can see that our review has been submitted. We have 4 users in total. 2 have been approved, 1 denied, and 1 don't know. You have some other settings on the left navigation bar, but let's go into results. Here we can see the members, we can see the outcome, the reason that we've provided, and who reviewed the membership, as well as the recommended action. We can also stop and reset this review and download a report. So let's click on download and open the file. The CSV file is giving us an overview of what has been done for this review. So let me expand it. And even though we only had 4 users in that group, you may have hundreds of users. So this CSV file might be very useful. If you want to connect, don't be shy and have a wonderful time watching the sessions.